Something I forgot to do during part 1.5. A little stuck on the end there. Now on to part 2.
CarawanCo presents a CarawanCo puzzle production. An unboxing, construction, and review.
Behind the scenes.
Hello everyone, and welcome to CarawanCo Puzzle Productions, where life is a puzzle. This is part 2 of my channel update video, and today I have, as advertised last time, UGears phone stand, or foldable phone holder, as it's called. Let's face it, everyone would call it a phone stand. And according to the site, this thing's assembly time is supposed to be approximately 1 hour. Now, according to the information, this thing can fit multiple phones, multiple size phones, I mean, not more than one phone at a time. And it's got some rubber bands on it. Well, I'll just describe all this after I've constructed it. It's giving me a lot of editing headache. But, back when I bought this, this was a new product for UGears. So, let's get right to it. And, judging by the size of this package, I mean, here's my phone. It's almost the exact same size. Now, on the back here, it mentions something about a spring, I think, I saw somewhere in here. Materials. Sanded plywood, rubber, candle wax, metal spring. So this isn't pure friction. Judging by the... there's a picture up here that shows how to operate it. Rather than editing that in now, I'll just show it to you. Tell you when the construction is completed. Assuming I can get this thing open. Wow, these flaps are deep. See if I have any better look on the top side here. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Got the rubber bands. Got the spring here, and we got wax. Kind of a thick construction booklet. I mean, And finally we have the pages. And that's all in the box. We have 4 sheets. So, let's get to work.
You might be a little far away. Zoom you in. That might be far enough. Okay. This should be far enough in, but if it isn't, I can always zoom in and out again. Or, zoom in and out. Sorry. Alright, let's get to work. Here we go. Page 1. think I will zoom in further. Here we go. I think that'll be good. Actually, it is still Ripley if I hold it up close. That's interesting. Hmm. As you just saw, I use this piece to press these pieces. He says, end of this piece. Never feel you're confined by the instructions. It didn't tell me to do that. Also, these instructions are telling me to pull parts out of the sheets before they're actually used. Oh no, wait a minute. This is the actual tool I'm supposed to use to press these in. Whoops. This is a tool. I did not realize this. Now I can add this tool to my collection. So, Yeah, there's no sandpaper in this. Kind of wish there was. A lot of rough edges. Alright. That sheet one. They actually carved this piece to where some areas of it, not sure if you can see that, are thinner than others. Oh, here. Lex. actually, let's... Now that is a tight fit. Now we turn this over.
Whoops. But only for that one step.
Yeah, you gotta loot these long pieces up so that they can slide into these tiny holes. Yeesh. Oh, okay, I see. There are indicators here showing you which way the cuts in the wood have to go. Yeah.
This part's a little tricky. Special notices here to have this piece a certain way. And it is raining, by the way. Just wondering what that background noise is. Spring. The spring. Ah, I missed something back here. Hmm.
UGears logo.
And shoot four.
The instructions here show to put this on the edge of your table so that you can have a nice firm press, but I'll press this off screen. Thank you.
Very light settings here. And I think this gets together. Is, yeah, that's as far as it can go. It's got a series of grooves in the underside here for your thumb. Or fingers, I guess, so that you can easily adjust this thing to the size of your phone. So I assume this is the end of it. Oh, nope, I forgot about the rubber bands. It actually shows doing the bottom one first, which was probably a smart idea. Right. And that's basically it. Yep. And there you have it. It's a bit of a loose fit. My phone has a case on it, so that may, yeah, that may hinder it, but okay.
Well, this is done. And it shall live over here for now. Okay, apparently I've got a blind spot in my camera. So, yeah, according to my overhead camera's timestamp, it took about an hour to build this thing. Also, I've got quite a few spare pieces in, since in the leftovers here. I'll be adding those to my collection. These pieces I can actually toss. I got another tool to add to the collection. Some wax. And I will set all of this to the side for now. Ladies and gentlemen, we are facing a bit of a crisis. I don't mean the viral epidemic, the epidemic we seem to finally be getting over, slowly as it may be. I mean get-rich-quick schemes. Now this may seem a little hypocritical of me, seeing as how I just built a phone stand, making it easier to do these sort of things. Things. And I may be a day late and a dollar short on this, or more precisely, a month late and a paycheck short. But I've recently been suckered into these things myself, so I felt I should address it. We've all seen the ads where robotic voices say things like, your current balance is 12 million blah blah blah. Or celebrities saying other apps force you to reach a certain point and before you can cash out. This one doesn't. This one doesn't. Or random people fanning huge stacks of bills, or making it rain, or being really excited about huge in-app awards after only an hour of play. A day at most. Sometimes only 10 minutes. But it's all lies. The only place these people got money from was by corporations paying them to be in these ads. If you know about any app that is not fake, I'd love to know about it. Otherwise, all these lies mean these people are committing the sin of false testimony. It's money. And I beg you to not feed their monetary addictions. If tapping a screen and watching videos to get you rich, which you should be getting paid for watching this video. But that's not going to happen. The world isn't going to give you anything. You have to earn it. Again, sorry about the storm outside. I beg you to do so by flexing your artistic muscles. So it's paint, write, play music, whatever. But do something you feel passionate about. Do something you enjoy doing. And support others who are as well. YouTube is simultaneously the easiest and hardest way to get noticed. The easiest because anyone with an internet connection and recording device can upload to it. The hardest because, due to the first, there may be thousands on it with your same type of talent. But please, don't fight these people. Join forces with them. Give constructive criticism, like and share their videos, subscribe to become members of and join their channels. And also see if they have Patreon accounts. Many look at YouTube's 1,000 subscriber requirement meant for ad revenue as harsh. But those subscribers are effectively your customers. If you have a business with only a few regulars, you're going to go into debt trying to keep it afloat. But if you have hundreds of faithful shoppers, you will continue to grow. Now, I will continue to upload every 2 weeks, every other Saturday, to give you all time to watch and comment, and for me to respond to them. I fully intend on replying to all comments. It may take time, but I will get to them. Now, please, support your local and long-distance creators. Please like, share, and subscribe to this video. And this has been the official part 2 of my channel update. Next time, we're going to do some puzzle art. Well, I may split that video up into 2 parts as well. I haven't decided yet. But regardless, until next time, God bless.